Hello everyone, today we will start with the new topic of unit 5, that is speed ratio in belt drive, slip of the belt drive and creep of the belt drive. So let's begin from the speed ratio. Now all we know, what is the definition of speed ratio? It is the ratio between the speed of driven pulley to the speed of driver pulley. As you can see in the expression, it is ratio of speed of driven pulley to the speed of driving pulley. Now we are going to calculate the speed ratio of the belt drive without slip and with slip. So first we will calculate by neglecting slip or without slip, and for that let's check with this dimension. That small d and capital D is nothing but the diameter of small pulley and large pulley. Here is the smaller pulley is the driving member. Then small n and capital N is nothing but the RPM of small pulley and large pulley. Similar way, small v and capital V is nothing but the speed of small pulley and large pulley. And at the end, VB is considered as speed of belt. Now let's derive the equation. First we calculate the speed ratio neglecting the slip. Now if there is a no slip, then speed of driver pulley and speed of belt is same. So here we have the speed of driver pulley, small v is equal to pi d n divided by 60. So it is equal to the speed of belt. And speed of driven pulley is also equal to the speed of belt, because again there is a no slip. So here we have the speed of driven pulley, capital V is equal to pi d n, that is d and n is capital, divided by 60. So we can write speed of that driven pulley is equal to speed of belt. And as you can see, the expression B and D, we can write VB is equal to small v is equal to capital V. It means that pi d n divided by 60 is equal to pi d n upon 60. Here pi and 60 get cancelled. So what we get, the speed ratio is equal to small d divided by capital D is equal to small capital N divided by small n. As we know the fact, diameter is inversely proportional to the RPM. So here we get, this is the expression of speed ratio of the belt drive. This is the expression without thickness. And if we add the thickness, then the equation become capital N divided by small n is equal to small d plus t divided by capital D plus t. This is the equation of the speed ratio of the belt drive neglecting slip. Now let's calculate the expression of the speed ratio by considering slip. Before that, we must understand the concept slip of the belt drive. And we already seen that power transmitted in case of the belt drive is due to frictional grip between belt and pulley. But in some case or sometime, what happened? The friction between the belt and pulley is insufficient, so there is power loss and speed loss. Or what happened if friction between the belt and pulley is insufficient? It may causes forward motion of the driving pulley without carrying the belt in it, or forward motion of the belt without carrying the driven pulley in it. Here we have the statement. First is forward motion of the driving pulley without carrying the belt, and second is forward motion of the belt without carrying the driven pulley. Therefore, there is a difference between the linear speed of the pulley and the belt, and this is called as slip of the belt. I hope you understand the concept. Let's go for the expression. Now, slip is generally expressed in terms of the percentage. So here we have the S1 and S2 is the slip percentage. First is the slip percentage between the driving pulley and the belt, and second is the slip percentage between the belt and driven pulley. So let's calculate the linear speed of the belt by considering the slip percentage. So linear speed of the belt is equal to V, that is the speed of the driving pulley, minus of percentage of slip into V. So let's take, after taking the V common, we'll get V into bracket 1 minus of S1 divided by 100. So, and we know the V is pi d n upon 60 into bracket 1 minus of S1 divided by 100. Similar way, let's calculate the linear speed of the driven pulley by considering the slip. So speed of the driven pulley is equal to VB minus of percentage of slip into VB. So again, take VB common, it will be get 1 minus of S2 upon 100. So VB is equal to this V that is the speed of the driven pulley divided by this term, that is the V divided by 1 minus of S2 divided by 100. Okay, and what is V? V is nothing but the pi capital D capital N divided by 60, and this term remains as it is. So we'll get to expression for VB. VB is equal to this term, that is equation A, and VB is equal to this term, that is equation B. So let's equate equation A and B. So we'll get, so after equating equation A and B, we'll get this term. So in this term, the pi and 60 get cancelled. So let's rewrite the equation by taking the diameter at one side and speed at another side. It become this D. This D is more right here, so small d upon capital D, 1 minus of S1 upon 100. Again, we'll take or shift this term in this side, so it become 1 minus of S2 divided by 100 is equal to what remains is capital N, and here is the small n, so shifted on right side, it become capital N upon small n. So after solving this equation, we'll get small d upon capital D into bracket 1 minus capital S upon 100, where S is nothing but the S1 plus S2 is equal to capital N upon small n. So as we can see the expression, the result of slip is reduce the speed ratio. But as we know, the slipping is the common phenomena in case of the belt drive. So when there is a need of the definite speed ratio, we cannot use the belt drive. Here we have the expression of speed ratio by considering the thickness, that is capital N divided by small n is equal to d plus t divided by d plus t into bracket 1 minus of S upon 100. That is all about the slip of belt drive. I hope you understand. Now let's move towards the next concept, that is creep of belt drive. Before go for the creep, we must know about this term, that belt is always in tension when it is used to transmit the power from driving pulley to driven pulley. But what happens when the driver pulls the belt, the tension at this end is the high, so it is the tight side, and when it releases the belt, then tension at that end or upper end is less, then it becomes the slack side. Now see the concept of creep. When belt passes from the slack side to tight side, certain portion of the belt will extend or expand, and when it is passes from this tight side to slack side, then it contract again. And due to this change of length, there is a relative motion between the pulley and belt, and this phenomena is termed as or called as the creep of the belt. The effect of creep is slightly reduce the speed of driven pulley. So we can calculate that by using this expression, that N2 upon N1 is equal to D1 upon D2 into E plus under root of sigma 2 divided by E plus under root of sigma 1, where sigma 1 and sigma 2 is stress in belt on tight side and slack side respectively, and E is nothing but the Young's modulus of the material of belt. And symbol D1, 1 is represent the smaller pulley and 2 is represented the larger pulley. I hope all of you get this point. The slip of the belt and creep of the belt are important as far as examination concerned. Short note is asked on the slip and creep of the belt. So here we stop. Thank you.